Welcome back to OneStopTutorials.com. Alibaba here again. How you all doing, you crazy, crazy Dreamweaver people? We got a lot to do in this tutorial, so we're going to get straight into it. First things first, we need to open up our special editions page, which is under our website. Double click special editions, go to the design view, and this is where we got up to last time. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to simply delete that shopping cart. Just click on it and delete. And because we want to add our own table, so we want to get on with it. We want to go to insert, layout, table, click on that, and we want to choose for this tutorial, we want two rows, two columns, table width 100%, padding 5, cell spacing 5. That will be okay. And there we go, we have our table. So what do we need to do? Well, first we need to merge these tables together. You know what, I could do with just one and one really. I'm going to show you how to delete some tables because we don't need these second lot. You simply highlight in one, holding down your left mouse, drag across the bottom one, hit delete on your keyboard. That's simple. It's that simple to do. Okay, I'm going to come in my side panel here and we're going to go to images, special offers, and you'll notice we have two images in here. We want to use the dragon one. I'm going to left click on the dragon, drag it into the left cell. I'm going to type in a dragon. We're going to name our picture, keep it tidy, and there we go, we got our dragon in. Now what I want to do is I want to come down to the text file and I want to choose special editions, dragon age, double left click on that, it will open it in Dreamweaver, and I just want to copy everything, right click, copy, control C if you wanted to do it, right click, paste, and there we go, we got our information in. Now I see a problem, the cell is centered, but we all know how to fix that by now. Simply click in the left cell, come down to vertical, change it to top, that's at the top. We'll do the same for this one, and there we go, everything's looking good. So let me shut that down. So what we want to do is I want to put the price $14.99, I want to put that underneath the picture. So I'm just going to highlight this text, right click, and it's out of view, but you go to cut or control X, and I want to click next to the image, I want to hold down shift and I want to hit enter, that will move the space down, and then control V to paste it in, and there's our text. So if we were to quickly preview this in the browser, let's have a look what it looks like. Come on, what's going on? Preview it in the browser. Okay, you'll notice that we got a problem. We got a problem that this is far too close to this image. We need to be able to get in there and format it ourselves. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to have to use a div tag. Now a div tag is very simple. It has a div at the beginning, it has a closing div, anything in between it is contained in that div. So if I highlight this code and I go to code view, you'll notice here we have price $14.99. Now to make a div tag is very simple, just you need to type exactly the same as me, hold down shift and the two brackets next to the M on the keyboard, hold down shift and hit div, close. So that's the first one, div, and after the 9 at the end, we just want to do the same again, ding, and then this time we want to hit backslash, and there we go. We have made ourselves a container, so now we have our div, and we've closed our div, and everything in the middle of it is contained inside this div. Okay, you'll get to understand it more. Just type it exactly the same and there won't be a problem. So when we come back to the design view, you'll be able to see straight away that we have this line going all the way around our price. Okay, and that's good, we're actually in a div. So if we select that div by hovering over the line, you'll see that the line goes red. Just simply left click, you'll now notice it turns to a blue line. Okay, and we want to come back down to our page properties, and since we've done that, you'll notice under page properties there's something called div ID. We now want to name this div tag, so we're going to name it what should we name it, price. Type in price, hit enter, and you'll notice now that that is named. So if we were to come back into the code view, you would be able to see div, sorry, I'm just killing mosquitoes, they're attacking me here, div ID, and it's giving it the name of price, what we just named it. Very good stuff. Okay, now we have that done, what we want to do now is we want to format this div tag. So very simply, go back and select that div by hovering over the actual line, or come down to your tab tab here and select it. So you want to select this div. There you go, div. We want to, let's just close this options down. We want to come into our side panel and we want to go up to CSS, which is at the top here, and we want to make a new rule. If you do this with the div selected, notice what happens when we make a new CSS rule. Automatically does it for you, puts it into the right place, and it makes you your CSS div for that name price. So we're going to hit OK. Now what we can do is we have so much more power. We can now come in here, we can change the size to 18. Okay, we can make the font weight bold, color black. And then what we also want to do is we want to play around with the box settings. If you go to box, you notice under padding, okay, we want to, because it, as it's so tight, we need to move, so we need to move the pixels down from the top. So we want to add, let's say, 10 pixels. If we hit apply, you'll see what happens. You'll notice this area here has now a 10 pixel padding. It's looking good. And maybe we also want to center it, so we have to adjust the left hand side. So we're going to put left 15 pixels, and that will move it into the middle. And as you can see here on the left, it's made it into that. I also think if we come back to type, I think 18 is too big. Let's make it 16. Hit apply and hit OK. Now when we preview this in the browser, let me just show you the style sheet. When we preview this in the browser, you'll notice we've had it more centered and we've had more space now, and we can come in at any time and change that. Excellent stuff. Next thing we need to do is we need to do exactly the same. So click at the end of the div tag, hit enter. Now we want to insert our shopping cart. Okay, so go back to the shopping cart, fat free. And we want to take the code from form, starting at form, finishing at form. Okay, start form, finish form, control C or right click, copy, come back in, go to the code views, code view, and control V to paste. Okay, and you'll notice we now have our shopping cart in there. We want to do exactly the same for the shopping cart. So we want to select the shopping cart just so you can see it in the code view. And there it is. Starts at form, and we want to do exactly the same with the div. We want to do the div tag again, okay, and we want to close it again at the end of form. So it starts form and begins in form. So I'll do one bracket, backslash, and it will finish it off for me, okay. Now we'll have that selected. So let me just close this down. If we come to our page properties, if we come to our tag, you'll see our div tag here. We want to name this, what do we want to name this? Shopping. Again, if we hit enter, if you'll see it's div ID, we come back into our side panel, go up to our CSS, add create a new CSS, it's done it all for us again, hit OK. And this time we want to add, what should we add? Let's add some padding from the left. So we're going to go to box. And we're going to uncheck same for all, and padding on the left, we're going to type in 15 pixels like we did before, hit apply, and that should be okay. We can always come back in and edit it in a minute. Let me just save this style sheet. Now when we go and preview this, let's have a look, see what it looks like. Okay, you can see that we've got it centered, but we need more padding at the top. Okay, let's come back into Macromedia. Let's go back to that style sheet that we just made, shopping, double left click on it, and come back into the box. And this time we want to bring the top down, so let's add a padding of 10 pixels at the top, hit apply, hit OK. Now let's go back in, and it's Mr. Annoying style sheet again. And let's go and preview this one more time. Now you'll notice it looks tidier, and we can keep playing with the settings until we get it perfectly. Yeah, so it's looking really, really good. I'm going to move this across so we haven't got so much space happening there. Sorry. And there we go. We have now our first box in, and in the next tutorial, we're going to finish this off and duplicate it and get our next one. Take it easy, guys and girls. Thank you for watching my Dreamweaver course. Any questions, please let me know. Laters.